Hello children, welcome back to the math class. Yesterday we discussed up to three Romans. Okay, now let us start fourth question. If tan A is equal to cot B, where A comma B are acute angles. Prove that A plus B is equal to 90 degrees. Okay. Now this is the question. Tan A is equal to cot B. So this is given condition ma, where A and B are acute angles. Acute angles means below 90 degrees. Now we want to prove that A plus B is equal to 90 degrees. So first of all, we have to take given condition. So what is that given condition? Tan A is equal to cot B. Already yesterday class I explained to you complementary angles. What are those? Sin 90 minus A is equal to cos A. And cos 90 minus A is equal to sin A. And tan 90 minus A is equal to cot A. Same cot 90 minus A is equal to tan A. And secant 90 minus A is equal to cosecant A. Next, cosecant 90 minus A is equal to secant A. So these are the complementary angles formulas. These are. Okay. Now here given condition is tan A is equal to cot B. But here variables are there. A and B. Okay. So how to find the complementary angle of A? Here numeral is there means you have to calculate easily. But here variable is there. So, not able to find complementary angles. So, that's why this tan A is in the form of like this. Here tan A. Tan A formula is what? Cot 90 minus A. So, same in the place of tan A, write a cot 90 minus A. This is equal to right side as this right, cot B. Now, cot cancel. 90 minus A is equal to B. Now minus A moves to right side, plus A plus B. Okay, therefore A plus B is equal to 90 degrees. Now hence proved. So we want to prove that A plus B is equal to 90 only now. Now hence proved. And next is some. Next question number 5. Interior angles. Interior angles of a triangle ABC. Then show that tan of A plus B by 2 is equal to cot C by 2. Cot C by 2. Now this is the question mark. A, B, C are interior angles of a triangle. Triangle name is ABC triangle. Then we want to show that tan of A plus B by 2 is equal to cot C by 2. Okay. So given condition is what? A, B, C are interior angles of triangle ABC. So everyone knows. Suppose this is a triangle. In this triangle, this is what type of triangle? ABC is a triangle. Okay. So, in this ABC triangle, these three are the interior angles. Okay. So, that means ABC is a, here not mentioned what type of triangle. That means that is isosceles, that is, or otherwise equilateral, isosceles, right angle, whatever it is. Any triangle. But these three are the interior angles. Interior angles means everyone knows angles and property, no? So, sum of three angles is equal to 180 degrees. So, take that condition, angle sum property. With the help of that property only, you have to calculate this sum. So, first of all, write given condition. A, B, C are interior angles. Interior angles of triangle ABC. sum of three angles is equal to 180. Okay, with the help of the singular angles, you will get the condition a plus b plus c is equal to 180. But here we want to prove that tan a plus b by 2 and tan c by 2. Observe this expression. Here a plus b is one group and c is another group. And that too, the denominator 2 is there, by 2 by 2. Here 2 not there. So that's why, so as our purpose, we have to divide on both sides by 2. So that means a plus b plus c by 2. Right side also 180 degrees by 2. 2 times here 90 times cancel. So a plus b plus c by 2 is equal to 90 degrees. Okay. But in this expression, a plus b is belongs to one group and c is another group. No? Same here a plus b plus c. Three variables are there. So this expression also you can divide it into two parts. So a plus b one group. That means a plus b by 2 and another one is c by 2 is equal to 90. Now this c by 2 moves to right side. Here also right side only there now, c by 2. So that's why this c by 2 moves to right side. A plus b is equal to 90 minus c by 2. 90 minus c by 2. But in this expression, IHS plus what ratio is there? Tan ratio is there. So as our purpose, here also we can add in. That means applying tan on both sides. So tan of a plus b. Sorry, ma'am, here by 2 also there. So a plus b by 2 is equal to tan of 90 minus c by 2. 90 minus c by 2. Now left side as is right, tan of a plus b by 2. Tan of 90 minus c by 2. So this is looking like complementary angle. 90 minus something is there. So this 90 means complementary. Tan of complementary angle. See this. Tan 90 minus a. For me is what? Cot a. But a is there. So that's why here write a. But in the place of a, how much is there? C by 2. That means tan opposite is cot. A plus how much is there? C by 2. So that's why here write cot c by 2. Now hence prove. Now this is only no answer. Finish. The same model, example 12. Same model, example 12 is there. But here sign and cos words are there. Okay, sign and cos ratios are there. Same process by solving up to this. After that, adding in the place of tan, you have to write sign only. Okay, so that is example 12. So this is very important sum. So you practice that also. Next. So in this exercise one more sum is there. So that is 6th one. Express sine 75 degrees plus cos 65 degrees. In terms of trigonometric ratios, of angles between 0 degrees and 45 degrees. Now this is the question. Express sine 75 plus cos 65 in terms of trigonometric ratios of angles between 0 to 45. So see this question. Sine 75 plus cos 65. This is the question. Okay. So in this angles we can convert it into 0 to 45. That means in between 0 and 45. So here more than 45 angle is given now. But this after simplifying this angle we can convert into 0 to 45. Okay. Now take the question. Sine 75 plus cos 65. This is only different question in this whole exercise. See carefully. So first of all take first term. sin 75. So here question meaning is that only angles change to 0 to 45. Okay. So here sin 75 is there. So this 75 is converted into complementary angle. Okay. So that means complementary angle of 75 is how much? Sin. Here angle. Before some variables are there. So variables are not able to find complementary angles. No. So that's why it is converted into this LHS form. But in this question, 75 number is there, numerator. So it is easily find the complementary angle. So how to find complementary angle of 75? Everyone knows complementary means 90. 90 minus 75. Subtract what? 10 minus 5, 5, 8. 8 minus 7, 12. So that means complementary angle of 75 is answer 15. So that's why here write 90 minus 15. 90 minus 15, 75 only, no? So after that, observe here sine. This is in the form of sine 90 minus a. Sine 90 minus a. So form means what? Sine 90 minus a, cos a. Cos a plus how much is there? 15 degrees. So first term is finished. Next is second term. That is cos 65. Cos here also find complementary angle 90 minus. 90 minus how much is equal to 65? 90 minus 25. Subtract once. 10 minus 5, 5, 8. 8 minus 2, 6. Okay. Now it is in the form of cos 90 minus a. Cos 90 minus a. Formula is what? Sin a. So sin a plus how much is there? 25. The first term answer is cos 15 and second term answer is sin 25. Now write as it is. In the place of sin 75, write that answer cos 15. And second term cos 65, that answer is sin 25. Write this answer. Sin 25. Now this is the answer. Observe here. So sin and cos, both words are same. But in this is 75 and 65. So this angles are changed to below 45 degrees. Below here 0 to 45. And target is given now. So in between 0 to 45 only you will get the answer. Okay. Now this exercise is finished, ma'am. This complementary angles concept is over. Next coming to trigonometric identities. Trigonometric identity. So everyone knows identity. What is called identity? So in 8th class and 9th class here everyone studied algebraic identity. What is called algebraic identity? Algebraic equation is also called an algebraic identity but it is true for all the values of the variables involved in the equation. So for example, a plus b whole square, a minus b whole square, a plus b whole cube, a minus b whole cube. So all these are algebraic identities. In the same way, here the topic is trigonometric identity. So what is called trigonometric identity? Trigonometric identity means identity equation in terms of trigonometric ratios of angles is called trigonometric identity. So simply say that an identity is also called as a trigonometric identity, but it is true for all the trigonometric angles, trigonometric ratios of the angles. That means already I explained trigonometric angles, no? Sin 0 degree, sin 30 degree, sin 45, sin 60, sin 90. So all these angles 0, 30, 45, 60, 90. These 5 types of angles are trigonometric angles. Okay. So we have to take any identity. In that trigonometric identity, it is true for all the angles involved in the trigonometry table. Okay. So here 3 identities are there. So first identity is cos square a plus sin square a is equal to 1. And second identity, 1 plus tan square a is equal to secant square a. And third identity, 1 plus cot square a is equal to cosecant square a. Now these three are the identities. Okay. So
थैंक यू चलिए।